Welcome to worship here at St. Paul Lutheran Church in New City, New York. I'm the Reverend Rhonda Hain, pastor of St. Paul's Lutheran Church and Christian Day School. We are here to be enriched in faith through the word, the prayers, and our worship together. And so we begin in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Come, you thankful people, come, praise the Son of Harvest Home. All is safely gathered in, ere the winter storms begin. God our Maker does provide for a wants to bear supplies. Come to God's own temple, come, praise the Son of Harvest Home. All the world is God's own field, brought unto His praise to yield. Wait and test or gather song, up to joy or sorrow grown. First the blade and then the ear, then the full corn shall appear. What of harvest crops that wear, or some grain and pure may be. For the Lord of God shall come, and shall take His harvest home. From His field shall in that day all offenses purge away. Give His angels charge at us, in the fire of days to cast, but the fruitful years to store in His corner evermore.
Psalm 90. Lord, from age to age, you are God.
Our iniquities you have set before you,
and our secret sins in the light of your countenance.
The span of our life is 70 years, perhaps in strength even 80.
Yet the sum of them is but labor and sorrow.
And they pass away quickly, and we are gone.
So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom.
Let us pray together the prayer of confession found in the bulletin. Faithful God,
have mercy on us.
We confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves.
We turn from
your loving embrace and go our own ways.
We pass judgment on others
before examining ourselves.
We place our needs first
and withhold necessary resources from others. Please observe a moment of quiet meditation for your personal confession to God. And we pray together.
By your grace, forgive us.
Through your love, renew us, and in your spirit, lead us,
so that we may live and serve you in newness of life. Amen.
My friends, we stand upon this good news. If we confess our sin, God is faithful and just, and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Thanks be to God. Amen. Welcome, young people. I'm delighted that you're here. Today's gospel is a parable. It's a story that Jesus talks about to tell us how to share our gifts, our talents with others. And to do that, I'd like us to take a look at this Pentecost tree. Now, in the parable, Jesus tells us not to be afraid to share our gifts, our talents with others. Jesus says that he doesn't want us to bury our talents. So when you look at the Pentecost tree, you see underneath there are a bunch of graves, a bunch of places where someone might bury their gifts and talents and not allow them to be used to grow something beautiful and lovely in the world. So we're talking about gifts and talents. Have you ever asked what your gifts and talents might be? Well, take a look at this picture. Jesus teaches us, like I said in this story, to use our talents. So when you look at this picture of many talents, what do you see? There's someone playing basketball. Maybe you're good at working on team sports and working with others. There's someone playing the piano. Maybe you play the piano or a musical instrument as a talent. There's a boy to the right on his computer, on his iPhone, texting someone. Maybe you're good at communicating with others. There's someone skateboarding. There's another girl in the center of the picture on a computer. Maybe you have great computer skills. There's a boy baking cookies. Someone else swimming. Another person reading. These are just a few examples of talents or gifts. What gifts or talents do you have? Let's go back to our Pentecost tree. Again, Jesus says, don't bury your talents, but use them. Use them to help and be a blessing to others. So what gifts or talents might you share? Well, if you're good at computers, maybe you could help mom or dad or maybe a grandparent learn better how to function in the new age of technology. You might even want to help pastor with that because I struggle. Maybe you're good at cooking. Might want to help mom or dad with a dinner. Maybe you have talents with arts and crafts. Have you ever thought about making an old-fashioned card to someone who's sick or someone who's lost a loved one? That would give them great encouragement. Whatever your gift, your talent, your ability, use it. Use it for the good of others. When we share our talents, our love grows, just like this Pentecost tree. People are helped, and the world is a better place. Let us pray together. When we pray, we fold our hands, we bow our heads, we close our eyes. Thank you, God, that you have given me many gifts and talents. Help me to use my gifts to love and serve others and help make a better world. For we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
As long as you are near, please be.
Should make good use of the gifts God has provided them. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew chapter 25, beginning with the 14th verse. Glory to you, O God. Jesus said to the disciples, "For it is as if a man going on a journey summoned his slaves and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. The one who had received the 5 talents went off at once and traded with them and made 5 more talents. In the same way, the one who had 2 talents made 2 more talents. But the one who had received the 1 talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those slaves came and settled accounts with them. Then the one who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 more talents, saying, 'Master, you handed over to me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more talents. His master said to him, "Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master.' And the one with the 2 talents also came forward, saying, 'Master, you handed over to me 2 talents. See, I made 2 more talents. His master said to him, "Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master.' Then the one who had received the 1 talent also came forward, saying, 'Master, I knew that you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and I hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours.' But the master replied, 'You wicked and lazy slave, you knew, did you, that I reap where I did not sow and gather where I did not scatter? Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers. And on my return, I would have received what was my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to the one with the 10 talents. For to all those who have, more will be given, and they will have an abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace, mercy, and peace be yours from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Friends, what a gospel! A harsh gospel. One filled with joys and difficulties. Like to begin with a story.
as we try to get to the meat, the heart of what Jesus is saying to us for today and now. Long time ago, I heard a story about Michelangelo, the famous painter and sculptor. One day, a neighbor watched curiously as Michelangelo pushed a huge, huge piece of marble, a huge rock, down the street. After seeing him sweat and tug a while, the neighbor said to him, "Why are you working so hard over that old piece of stone?" Wiping his brow, Michelangelo answered, "I labor because there's an angel in this rock that wants to get out." He said, "I labor because there's an angel in this rock that wants to get out." I think of this story when I think of the gifts and the talents given to us. Everyone, every one of us, has the task of releasing angels from the God-given raw materials, the God-given raw materials in our lives. We are entrusted with the task of shaping and transforming our communities so that they become something amazing, building blocks of God's life in the world, that they become homes for hospitality, workshops for justice, hospitals for healing, meals for the hungry multitudes. We are tasked with using our gifts and talents, especially in our church and school, that we might become a spiritual center for the renewal of people's lives and spirits. Our gifts, our God-given talents, our abilities, our financial resources can be instruments for peacemaking, justice promoting, and community building. Uncovering these gifts, developing them, and using them are essential to our well-being. Today's gospel story talks about gifts loaned to us by God. God is the estate owner. We are the servants. Some of us know this parable is the parable of the talents. One talent in Jesus' day was worth 1,000 silver coins. However, this parable is far more than a story about how to manage money, the money entrusted to us. Like many parables, today's is full of good news. Good news to those of us who keep comparing ourselves to others. We hear from Jesus in this parable that the number of talents or the number of gifts we're given is not important. Whether we have 5 talents or 2 talents or 1 talent doesn't really matter. The point is this: if we use the talents we have, our lives will be enriched. Our faith communities will expand. Our capacity can double. If we don't use our talents, our lives and our faith communities and our nation and world, mind you, will diminish. We've heard this message in the New Testament before. The one who loses his life will find it. Cast your bread in the waters and it will come back tenfold. Today's gospel story says nothing about equality of gifts or equality of distribution. Today's gospel story is not very democratic. But it does promise the same reward to all who take risks of faith to use their gifts. The person who uses well the 2 talents, the 2,000 silver coins, hears the same pronouncement as the one who uses well the 5,000 silver coins. "Well done, good and trustworthy servant. You've been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." Right? Amazing words, whether 2 or 5. However, as a rule, we don't focus on those who are exercising their gifts in joy and freedom. In today's gospel story, it's the person who received the 1 talent, the 1,000 silver coins, who resonates with our experience and even moves us to compassion. His cautious, protective measures seem very reasonable. He says to the estate owner, I was afraid. So I went and I hid. I hid the talent and I buried it in the ground. We empathize with the servant, for I think Many of us would have done the same thing. And when the estate owner says, "As for this useless servant, throw him into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth," we hear those words and we protest. How can it be? Friends, today we wonder why there's less spiritual energy in ourselves, in our faith communities, in our world, why the things of God are dying. Where is the spiritual life and vitality we receive from God, the Holy Spirit in baptism, that gift in baptism of the Holy Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead? Where is the power? Where is the joy? Where is the life? Where is the fruit of the Holy Spirit in the world? We know those fruits: love and joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, self-control. Where are they? Today's gospel gives maybe an answer. If we don't use our God-given talents, our God-given gifts, our resources, we don't use them to make a better world, we experience anguish, the death of spirit, the death of spirit. We suffer. Our families suffer. Institutions implode. Nations crumble. Civilizations diminish. Churches die. Use it or lose it, as the saying goes. Our personal gifts, our relational gifts, our natural gifts, our material gifts are unknown. We don't own them. They are alone. We're stewards of them. They're unknown to us from God. The scriptures tell us to use them wisely. If we don't, we will suffer loss. It's a consequence. Today's parable encourages us to be generous and to take risky steps of faith. Now, the opposite of faith is not doubt. The opposite of faith is fear. Fear to take a step. Fear to dare to hope that there is an angel in the large, rough, massive marble within us. Fear to dare to hope there's an angel in that large, rough, massive marble around us, in our community, in our world. We know rock is hard. It's hard to work with. It's hard to manipulate. It's hard to move. Friends, the eyes of faith help us to see the hidden potential in maybe that family member that is just so burdensome and burdened and difficult. The eyes of faith help us to see the hidden potential in our leaders, in our colleagues, in our friends, in our parishioners. Eyes of faith help us to see our own potential. Maybe there's a writer or a musician or an artist or a speaker that wants to come out in you. Maybe there's a teacher or a deacon or a church leader or a school teacher, or a community activist, or a volunteer that wants to come out of you. Maybe there's a new program or a project embedded in our church or our school or in our community that wants or needs expression, but you're afraid. We're afraid, especially now in this era of coronavirus. We're afraid to take a step, a necessary step, because we may fail. And still, I hear Michelangelo's voice. He says, "I labor because there's an angel in the rock that wants to come up." Do we have that kind of vision? Even in horrific circumstances, bleak, dark, difficult circumstances, "I labor because there's an angel in the rock that wants to come up." Friends, I labor as a pastor among you here because I see within you and among you the possibility for new life, the new life, a new day out of the ashes and difficulty of this excruciating time. It could be a new day for our congregation and our school and our community of faith. And so my God-given talents are being used among you. Will those using gifts continue? Will those with gifts to develop and share join me? In the church, in the school, in this community? What resources are you willing to use to serve God? Here, through St. Paul Lutheran Church or Christian Day School. Like I said with the kids, our talents aren't meant to be dug in a hole and buried, or even buried in the crevices of our own life. They're meant to be used for the good of others. Friends, our talents and gifts are not our own. They are entrusted to us. Someday, that's what the parable says, someday there will be an accounting. May we use our gifts and talents wisely, in love and service to God, each other, our community, and our world. May we work together to make angels out of stone. Let it be so. Amen.
Assistance to those in need. I especially call your attention to supporting
our Rockland County Food Pantry, People to People, and maybe writing a check, bringing some food over to the site here in Nyack, West Nyack, to help them gather foodstuffs for Thanksgiving. Very worthy cause, and the amount of people who are in need of food is really staggering. So those are ways you can help in terms of making an offering. You may choose to offer financial assistance to our church so that we as a Christian community can continue to do God's work in the world. If you'd like to make a financial contribution to St. Paul Lutheran Church, you may drop a check and a note in the mail to us, or you can turn to our website and click on a secure giving link on the website, which is St. Paul New City.Church. STPAUL New City.Church. Thank you for your generosity. Now we continue with our prayers. Prayers of thanksgiving. After each petition, Helen or I will say, "Blessed be the Lord," invite you to respond by saying, "Thanks be to God." God, our provider, we thank you for our family, friends, colleagues, church, and all who walk with us and support us in faith and life. We thank you for our food, water, clothing, shelter, health care, and all the ways you support our well-being. Bless we the Lord.
Thanks be to God. God of peace, you desire harmony in our relationships, in our relationship with you, and our relationships with each other. Thank you for promising to be near, never leaving or forsaking us. Thank you that your peace will guard our hearts and minds as we entrust our worries, concerns, and conflicts to your care. Blessed be the Lord.
Thanks be to God. God, our protector, we thank you for the many people who protect us from harm and heal us from injury. We remember our armed forces, firefighters and first responders. We remember contractors, public health officials, and all caring for those who are sick or in nursing care facilities. We remember scientists and researchers developing vaccines. We remember janitorial and sanitation workers and all essential workers and their families. Bless be the Lord.
Thanks be to God. God, our Creator, we thank you for the beauty and color of fall days, for the good earth and the plants, animals and people entrusted to our care. Thank you for creating humankind in your image and marking us with the cross of Christ forever in baptism. Thank you that your love and care is constant amid all the changing seasons in our lives. Bless be the Lord.
Thanks be to God. God, our helper, we observe this moment of silence to offer our personal prayers of thanksgiving to you. Bless we the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gracious God, you alone are worthy of praise. We offer our thanks in the name of Jesus.
Amen. And now the prayers of intercession. Longing for Christ's reign to come among us, we pray for the outpouring of God's power on the church, the world, and all in need. Lord of the church, ignite your people with the passion of your love. By the fire of your Holy Spirit, unify us across ministries, congregations, and denominations, and refine us to participate in your activity throughout the world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of creation, we stand in awe at the works of your hands and praise you for the beauty of nature. Bless the earth for your glory and restore its integrity where exploitation has caused ruin. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of the nations, sound forth your justice in the ears of all leaders. Increase concern for those who are the most vulnerable, especially as international leaders forge trade agreements and cooperate to end human rights abuses. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of all in need, search out all who cry to you in distress. Scatter the heavy clouds of depression, chronic illness, unemployment, and loneliness with your radiant light. Send us encouragement and signs of your healing. We remember all on our prayer list, especially Ellie, Jody, Gundrum, Zoya, Carolyn, Lucille, Barbara, Kirsten, Lillian, Bud, Debbie, Jane, Joan, Lorraine, Ben, Lori, Marie, Lori, Dwayne, Immacula, Irene, Clancy family, Bay, the Gripsland family, Helene, Julia, Luella, Eileen, Kevin, the Smith family, Linda, Jim, Bruce and family, Arlene and family, Helen and family, Cynthia and family, and the Bragard family. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of the stranger, stir up holy restlessness in us to extend love to those at the margins. Release our desire for control and open us to learn from the perspective of others. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of the living and the dead, we give you thanks for all the saints at rest from their labors. Rouse us to live by their example, that saints yet to come may also know your love. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. Receive our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Until that day when you gather all creation around your throne, where you will reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
And now we sing together the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Friends, there are another number of announcements. I encourage you to read the bulletin announcements carefully. And now, receive the blessing.
May the Lord bless and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you and give you his peace.
Go in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shadow of turning,
Lord.